Louis Farrakhan, you know him. You don't get more militant than him. You don't get more anti-Semitic, anti-white. You just don't. All right. He's at the top of the chart. So apparently, a lot of celebrities don't really understand who he is. And in 1990, Farrakhan went on the Phil Donahue show and said this.
Black people who were brought to this country were stripped of their names, language, culture, religion, God, and taken totally away from the history of themselves. You've painted Jesus white, God white, the angels white, and then all these black people have been subjected to a form of white supremacy, which produces in the reverse a black inferiority. Whites fear violence from us. We do not have a history of killing white people. White people have a history of killing us. After 400 years of living and experiencing, we're not prejudiced. We are looking at the reality of what we have suffered and continue to suffer.
All right, so after that clip resurfaced recently, celebrities like Jennifer Aniston, there's Jennifer again, Jennifer Garner, Michelle Pfeiffer, Jamila Jamilo, Sean Hayes, Lisa Rinna, Busta Rhymes, Ice Cube, all retweeted or praised Louis Farrakhan, Minister Farrakhan. Now, in the Donahue clip, he sounds kind of rational. Let's take another clip. Go.
The powerful Jews are my enemy.
The Jews were responsible for all of this filth and degenerate behavior that Hollywood is putting out, turning men into women and women into men.
And Satan is going down. And Farrakhan, by God's grace, has pulled the cover off of that satanic Jew. And I'm here to say, your time is up. Your world is through.
Now, I'm going to tell you that those Hollywood people that retweeted that don't know anything. They don't know who Louis Farrakhan is or what he stands for, what he's done in the past. But these people have influence.
Bill O'Reilly is back on TV and only on the 1st. No Spin News, every weeknight at 8 p.m. Eastern, only on the 1st.